I think it's important to know that there are all sorts of people at university. There's no such thing as a typical student, and I think that's how it should be. There's no one mold that you need to fit.
Hi, my name is Changavy. I'm a fifth year medical student. I moved to the UK when I was 8, and this is my Imperial journey. The reason I wanted to be trained in London was that London is a multicultural city. You see loads of different patients, and I think Imperial in particular has some of the leading consultants, some of the best doctors in the country, with hospitals like St Mary's, which is where Kate Middleton gave birth, by the way. So like, it's a great place to be at for your obs and gynae placement, for instance.
So life as a student in London, I think it's great because, especially in your first 2 years, there's a lot of free time. I feel like everything you want to do is close to you or easily accessible. If you're into fitness, if you're into gym, if you're into sports, there are loads of clubs, societies, not only within Imperial, but you can also go to general ones in London. And I think that's the advantage of being in a city. It's the fact that there are so many things at your doorstep. Clubs and societies have made such a huge part of my life at Imperial, and I still feel like there are so many other clubs and societies I want to get involved in, and I just haven't had the time to. So like I said, because from an ethnic minority background, I joined cultural societies in my first year, so I've joined Imperial Tamil Society, Imperial Punjabi Society. I mean, I'm not Punjabi, but they were so welcoming, and I can say the same about every other cultural society. Even though I'm not part of that society yet, they've still welcomed me, and I made some really good friends through my societies. So I was a recipient of the Imperial Bursary in the first few years, and I think that really helped with my living expenses, my sort of helped me pay the rent, helped me pay it was obviously a good addition to whatever else I had, and it eased off that pressure on my parents as well initially, so that was really helpful. I mean, I came to the open day and I just felt like I belonged here. You know, I walked in and it was so busy. It was really good. It was a sunny day as well, so it looked really nice, and I felt like I belonged. So the worries I had coming into university as a fresher, I think this is quite similar to what anyone else would have as well. I think the main worries were, you know, whether would I fit in, would I sort of make the most of my time at Imperial. But in terms of being from an ethnic minority background, I don't think I had that worry specifically, because Imperial has so many cultural societies, and I knew about some of these, or I looked these up before I came to Imperial. I'd been to a few shows that Imperial hosted, so I knew Imperial has a huge ethnically diverse groups of people and societies. I live with my parents, I have a brother and a sister, so I'm the oldest one, and I have a younger brother, a younger sister. They're both very keen on coming to London for university. Oh, now that I've moved out and I come back home and I tell them about all the cool things I've done, and they're like, I want to go. South Kensington, it's a mix of art, culture, lots of events, and university life. South Kensington really feels like home for me, just because my campus is here. And again, like I said, there is a lot of things to do. So females wanting to go into STEM, I think females should just go for it. Don't be intimidated. Take your seat at the table. There's nothing that should be stopping you from doing that. And I think as females of our generation, it's our sort of responsibility to lead the way, and change that ratio that we often see nowadays.